Within Africa, there are four volcanoes which are actively erupting. These volcanoes are spread across much of the eastern rift zone of the continent and the Afar Triangle, but do not represent the only volcanically active region in Africa. Offshore of Madagascar, there are several volcanically active island chains which owe their existence to at least two volcanic hotspots. One of these islands, Grand Comore, which is about three-fourths the size of the island of Oahu, contains two active volcanoes. The most active of these volcanoes is Karthala, which typically erupts about once every 6 to 7 years. On August 22nd, this volcano began showing signs of unrest as an increasing number of earthquakes began on its western flank. As a result, its alert level was raised from green to yellow, and residents were advised to stay clear of the overall volcano. Karthala is a massive shield volcano with a large summit caldera that measures 3.5 kilometers long and 2.8 kilometers wide. This caldera formed through numerous large volume flank eruptions which drained its underlying magma chamber and explosive volcanic activity. Although many eruptions occur within this caldera, flank eruptions are incredibly common at this volcano, largely originating from two rift zones, one to the southeast and one to the north-northwest. These rift zones are why the island has such a peculiar shape. While these two rift zones represent common sites where eruptions are likely to begin, lava flows can also erupt theoretically anywhere on the island, so whenever an eruption does occur, towns could be put at risk. One notable lava flow in 1860 traveled 13 kilometers from the north summit of Karthala to the western coastline just north of the capital city of Moroni. This area is heavily populated, and if you look around the dense assortment of structures, you can see a number of young volcanic cones. Thus, if an eruption was to occur, there is a chance that it could begin in the vicinity of the capital. Of course, the change in alert level does not guarantee that an eruption will occur. Assuming that the latest unrest is caused by a new magmatic intrusion, the vast majority of times a magmatic intrusion does not result in a new volcanic eruption. Interestingly, despite being a shield volcano, eruptions at Karthala are almost consistently explosive, resulting in large amounts of volcanic ash being ejected. While the average eruption at Mauna Loa has a VEI of 0, the average eruption at Karthala has a VEI of 2. Most of the explosiveness in Karthala's eruptions is owed to the initial phase of its eruptions when shallow magma interacts with the area's water table. The water table is heated until it flashes to steam, and since the same massive steam takes up more volume than the water it once was, it causes an immense amount of pressure to build. Eventually, this pressure becomes too great, resulting in a series of phreatic or phreatomagmatic eruptions. Past eruptions of Karthala have repeatedly disrupted regional air traffic and covered thousands of homes in ash. While ashfall associated with eruptions at this volcano is generally light, the ash is fluorine-rich. This can contaminate the area's water supply, meaning that during any eruption, any water catching system should be covered. Drinking contaminated water with unhealthy amounts of fluorine can cause bones to easily break, among other effects. Luckily, eruptions when they do occur at Karthala are generally brief. Half of Karthala's eruptions have lasted under a week, with two recent eruptions lasting less than 24 hours in length. Thus, any damaging lava flows, cinder or spatter cone growth, and heavy ashfall are likely to only occur over a relatively brief time period. Of course, longer eruptions have occurred at this volcano but are relatively rare. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Michael Sowold, for supporting this channel.